Hi guys, Vin here. Let me show you something super interesting. This could be something that maybe you're familiar with, or it might be something new. There's something called correlations, right? Not the kind of correlations that you've been taught, but the correlation of what is actually happening now and what actually happened before. Okay, we're not checking correlations whether a pair is positively correlated or negatively correlated. We are rather looking at correlation of patterns from now and the ones that actually took place. So I want to bring your attention back to 2019, around about December, the beginning of December, and I'm going to compare it with what is actually happening now, right? So we just want this portion where price was going up, going up, going up. Of course, this is not going to be the same move, but you can see that followed by a rise, drop, drop, a rise again, maybe a little bit of a drop, that, drop, that, go, drop again. Can you see that? And then a huge move, a huge move. Can you see? Can you see that? It's exactly what's happening now. And then followed by drop, correct, drop, drop, correct, drop. All right. And then what happened afterwards? So we're trying to map history. So these two are almost, this is 75% correlated. What actually took place here and what, or rather what is taking place now and what actually took place around that time. Can you see that? Very interesting. So there's more that you can do with the chart. So it's easy for me to actually forecast this, project this to that. I'm not sure if it makes sense. It's easy for me to project the future based on this correlation. Of course, also the fundamentals are going to be driving this, but it gives me a bit of an idea as to what to expect, right? Remember, I was telling you guys about selling the upside and having that. Okay. And we did find that. That's exactly what we got. But what are we anticipating going forward? We might see something, a move like that, maybe a bit of a hesitation, just like it happened there. A bit of a hesitation, which is actually what is happening now. If you pay attention, maybe it might also continue to the upside and then a push towards the area that we're forecasting for sales. So if you watched all the previous videos, you might have seen me talking about this. Also check the Telegram channel. So it's possible for us to do to look for those opportunities, maybe around 78% of this deck. Okay, so let me just do this on this particular 78 or 88 will do. In this case, you can see that price rallied from this lows, went up, got to 88, started selling. Okay, started selling in that fashion. So we're most likely to see the same thing around here. The price might start rallying up from here towards the 88 level, which is just around that particular shandy. Okay, and then it might start selling nicely in a correction like this. One, two, three. Okay, one, two, three, then it might start buying again once to the upside. But I just wanted to bring your attention to this kind of correlations whereby the current price action correlates with what actually took place before. Okay, so that's maybe this is new, maybe this is something that you've known for a while, but I just wanted to just show you guys that sometimes what is happening now probably happened before in a similar manner of some sort. So it might help you to project what to do next. Okay, what to do next. Of course, we need to keep everything the same. The reason why we bought around this because we're looking for a much lower price. If you watched previous videos, you will see that there was tons and tons of evidence as to why we should buy there. We're not looking at the concept of this particular move being correlated to previous moves. So yeah, that's something that this might be a little bit advanced if you're a beginner and to find these things and all that, but this is actually the shanties. This is actually the bay. Okay, so we might not necessarily to say that this is going to happen. Please, this disclaimer, disclaimer, disclaimer. Do not start buying without knowing why you are buying. Okay, this doesn't necessarily mean that since these things are like showing some sort of 75, maybe 80% correlation. Okay, it doesn't necessarily mean that price is going to move in that fashion entirely. Yes, let me just bring your mind back to how I got here. Look at that. Move up, correct, correct, correct. Move up, correct, correct, correct. Can you see that? Still the same thing, right? Correct, move up, correct, correct, move up. Maybe you're looking at that, move up, correct, correct. Okay, that was a deep correction of some sort. So you can see this is not exact, exact. Move up, correct, correct. Huge move up, correct, 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 correct. Can see that move up, we don't have move up as yet. That's why now we're saying that there's a possibility of us getting that move to the upside. That's why buys were super feasible. Maybe this is something advanced. Maybe this is something that is easier for you to see. But I just wanted to bring your attention to these two charts. This is from December. This is now. Okay. Similar moves that are taking place in the markets. All right. Should you find this video interesting, don't forget to share it. Like, dislike if you don't like what I'm doing. That don't be scared. No feelings attached. The dislike, give it a thumbs down. And don't forget to comment down in the description below. If you knew this, or if this is new, or if maybe this is interesting, let me know down in the description box below. So basically, if I was to put a title for this video, I was gonna say there's nothing new under this slide. Is that how they put it? Amor. Hey, English. All right, otherwise, sharp, sharp. My name is Bindi. I'm out.